Hello friends, welcome to our channel Coding Ka Keeda. Today in this video we are going to explore component, because component plays a very important role in our Angular project. When you start working on Angular, you will see component each and everywhere in your project. So you must know how to create component, how to add component in your routing, how to bind data on your HTML pages for display purpose, and how to pass data from your TypeScript to HTML, and how to pass data from one component to another component. So we'll discuss each and everything here by doing some crude operation. We'll also see how to bind data in HTML, how to pass HTML event to TypeScript in a component. So let's start it. So first of all, I have created a workspace in my app drive with the name Angular application, and now I will open this inside my Visual Code. You can also use command line and notepad for this application development, but I use Visual Code because it's pretty awesome and have lots of features. So now you can see here I have a workspace inside Visual Code. So next I will create a new terminal to write and execute commands. So first of all, we'll write command for create app, because now we have a workspace. Now we want to create our Angular application. So to do this, we will write command ng new and application name. One more thing, if you are using Angular for the first time, so you have to add Angular CLI inside your project or in a global level. I have added in a global level, that's why I'm not creating this. If you want to know in a detail, so watch our previous video where I have explained each and everything in a detail, like folder structure and how to set up these projects. Okay, now here it will ask for, do you want routing your application? So we'll select yes, and then it will ask for which type of CSS file do you want to in your application. So we'll normally select for the CSS extension. It will take some time, so I'm going to just skip this all. Now you can see we have a folder inside our workspace with my application name, as I have created task app. Now we'll test this default application as downloaded from this, that everything is in a right direction or not, or something is missing. So you just write ng serve to compile this and create a port where this application will host. By default it's 4200. For your application you can also change this. So now you can see this here, Angular demo project in front of you. Now we will add Bootstrap and jQuery in our application, so that we can create an attractive and responsive application and can use predefined classes in our HTML pages easily. So I'm just going to write npm install Bootstrap to download Bootstrap from npm node package manager and jQuery also. After installation of Bootstrap, you will find this inside your node module directory. Now we will add this CSS path to our application. So there are two ways, either you can add in index.html or you can add angular.json. So here we are adding inside angular.json. Now let's run this application to check whether this Bootstrap has been applied or not. Now you can see this changes, means Bootstrap has been applied. As discussed in our previous video, that everything you create like component and necessary files that require to change resides inside your app folder. So here you can see, now we'll start creating our component. So to create this component, you will just write ng generate component and then component name. As I am creating task component, so now you can see a task folder has been generated inside this app directory, and there are so many folders like CSS, HTML and testing file, and then TypeScript file. So we are basically deal with HTML and TypeScript file. Now we'll remove all auto-generated HTML from this app.component.html. And we'll add routing so that whenever you will start your application, it will run only task component, not this default app component.html. So we'll add routing inside our app.module.ts. So inside there is a root array where we'll just define path and the component. So whenever user will hit this path, like nothing written here as a root, then it will redirect to the task component. Now let's run this application to check it is okay or not. So now here you can see this, we are redirecting to our task component. Let's create user interface so that user can add their task start date and end date, and user can view all tasks added, and user have option to edit this task and have option to delete this task. So we are performing all crude operation here so that we can understand how to pass data from HTML to TypeScript in a component, and from component TypeScript pass data to component HTML. So here we'll work on task component.html. So here I have created a layout. On top there is a container. Inside this I have taken a row that will display all content to center, and inside this there is a column, and inside this there is a card. So inside card body we'll add all inputs like task name, start date and end date. So here I am explaining a trick that will be very useful for you. So whenever you want to create this input or div classes, so it will take lots of time to write all the code here. So in a single line you will create all this. So first of all you will write what you want to create, like I have added div, then dot, what class name you want. So I have added column, I want to column here, and then inside this, so it's a greater than parameter, inside this what I want. So inside this I want input type text, so just I have added, and before this I want to write how much rows I want. So here I have written like into 3. So it will create 3 column, then inside every column it will create input type text. So once you will enter, it will create like this. So it will very useful for you when you want to write a number of codes in a single line. Next, let's add placeholders so that you can easily identify in a UI. We'll also change its type. Now we also require a button to save this, so I'm going to just create a save button here. Next we will create a table where user can view data. In this table there will be option to edit and delete also. So here we'll add another card. Inside this card we'll add a table. Inside this table there is a column like name, start, and edit and delete. So let's run this application and we'll check how it's look like. Now we have a static HTML UI. Next we'll make communication between TypeScript and HTML file. So here I'm going to add like name with this type string, start string and string. These are basically will be converted as a model that I have already explained in my previous video, so there you can check this. So these model will be called inside our HTML. So let's look how we can create this. So you can see here, similar to this we can write the model name inside our HTML. This type of model used for two-way binding means whatever you will change inside your HTML, it will directly reflect to your TypeScript, and in TypeScript change will reflect inside your HTML. So you can see also this banana inside box. Next we'll add event on this save button to save fill data inside this input to our local array. So basically at this time we are not going for the API call and all, we'll make a separate session for this, how to call API and bind data from this. So that will work in a similar manner, but instead of this local you will call this API and get response. So here I have taken a function save data and a variable data as any type of array. Means any type means in this array you can fit any kind of object, like I have created here name, start or end. These objects I am pushing to this data array. Now we have data inside our array. So next we want to display this on our task HTML. So to do this we'll use ng for. It will loop on this array. So here I am going to write this let x of data, means it will create x object for this data array. Inside this data I have a property, so we'll write just x dot name, x dot start and x dot end. We'll also add edit and delete button here. Later on we'll add functionality to it, but till now we will add this. Here we'll add form module because it is used in input type when you are using ng model inside our input type, so it is required, otherwise you will face error. Now we'll run this and we'll add some detail like task and date. We'll save. So here you can see we have saved this data and display inside our this table. Now we'll add edit and delete functionality inside our these button. So we'll add edit function here and we'll pass the index of this array. So we'll add here let I is equal to index, so it automatically gives you index. And here we'll create a function edit and delete where we'll take index as a parameter. Inside edit function we'll take index as a parameter and we'll fetch this value by using this index. So now we have a selected index here. Next we have to keep this index on a global level so that when user will update, click on update button, so we can identify which row need to be updated. So we'll keep this edit index selected on a global level. Now we'll set all the data to input control for this update. So here you can see this, once user will click edit button, it will reflect inside this input box. Now we'll change this save button to update. Means once user will click edit, so this save button will change to update and this should be updated. Now we'll create update data function that will basically use to update record. So here we have a selected index for which we want to edit. So we will just update new object at this particular index. So we will write this, we are updating this value on a particular index inside this array. As it is updated, so we'll set -1 to edit index selected. Now we'll create one more button that is update and we'll add click event on this and assign this update data function to it. And thereafter we'll add condition on it because we want to check either show this save button or update button. So we'll put condition on edit index selected. If edit index selected is equal to -1, then means it's a first time and user want to save data. If you will select any edit index, so it will set inside this, so update button will start displaying. So let's check it. So here you can see, press on this edit button, now this update button is start displaying. Now we are going to add delete operation. So basically inside this function we are passing index as a parameter and this data will be removed from that array. So you can see here, when you click on delete button, it will remove from array and array is dynamically binding here, so it will reflect that removed. In our next video we'll discuss about TypeScript and we'll go step by step. If you are new here, so please subscribe to our channel so that you can get latest and updated videos notifications.